Hello, I'm Julien from Apwide, and in this video today we're going to see how to do the integration between Apwide Golive and Jenkins using pipelines. If you already watched the video about Bamboo integration, the use case is exactly the same. So let's start. As a reminder, we are in a company where we have several applications that are listed in Apwide Golive here. We have different type of environments, so different categories of environment, and we define instance of environment for different applications that we can see here. Right now, we don't have that much information in Apwide Golive, so we don't know how to reach the application. We probably collected the number of machines from another system. I don't know exactly from where. We don't know which version is currently available on this environment, and we even don't know the status of the environment. Now I'll switch back to Jenkins. In Jenkins, we already have the pipeline for the e-commerce application. We see here the different stages. We have the two first ones that are really the generic one provided by Jenkins, where we check out the source code, we install the tool. It's an application built with Maven. So first we have to make sure that Maven is correctly installed on the agent. Then we have our custom build and test. It's a Maven application, so a simple clean install. And then we deploy on dev environment. So when the build is successful, automatically we deploy that to dev. We see that we have an additional stage here that is deploy on demo. That is almost never executed because the build is a parameterized build. We can choose which environment we want to use to promote our artifact, and by default, that's the dev environment that is used. Now let's imagine that we have a developer from the e-commerce application team that just did a commit and will trigger the build, the pipeline. So I simulate that manually. First, Jenkins will check out the source code, make sure that Maven is installed, run the clean install that we see here. When the tests are correctly executed, we start the deployment procedure that we're going to see here. So test successful, deployment procedure just started. And when the deployment procedure started, we already have a synchronization that is done between Jenkins and Apwide Golive, where we have the status that is set to deploy. The pipeline is in success. We go back in Apwide Golive and we see that the status is back to up. We have the full history of the status changes. We know that it's the 2.22 that is available on this environment. We collected additional information about the database, the operating system, and even the email address of the owner of the environment. So what we can collect from Jenkins pipeline. And we have the URL of the application if we want to test it. So here we have access to the application. Now let's dig into the detail. So we have our Maven application, our e-commerce application with Jenkins pipeline. If we look at the Jenkins pipeline structure, we find our build and test stage. Okay. We have the deploy on dev and the deploy on demo environment. And how we do the integration with Apwide Golive, we use a shared library, Jenkins shared library that is provided. This shared library will add additional steps that you can use in your pipeline and that will pre-fill some attributes for you. So if I look at the definition of the deploy on dev, we see that we have an Apwide set environment status where we just have to define the deploy status. If I want to update the status for a specific environment, usually I have to provide the application, so e-commerce, and the category, so I can identify the environment, dev. But here, no need for that. I could do it, but the shared library is based to use some predefined environment variable. So here we see that we define the category, the dev category for the stage that deploys on dev. So we set the status, we update the environment with additional information, we set the deploy version from the POM file, and we set back the status to up when the deployment is finished. So here, that's the stage for depo and dev, and if I look at demo, I have the equivalent, but now I define the global variable as Apwide category set to demo. And that way we know that we are in the context of the demo environment. What is good with environment variables is that they can be defined at different levels in the Jenkins pipeline. So here we are at the stage level, but we are in the context of the e-commerce application and the full pipeline is dedicated to e-commerce application. So if I look at the pipeline level, we still have an environment directive, and here we'll create the app-wide application that is defined to e-commerce. In our company, we use just one single Jira instance. So if we have several pipelines for each application, to avoid the duplication between the pipelines, this variable can be defined at Jenkins global level. So if I go in the Jenkins configuration, in the global properties, I retrieve the Jira base URL and the Jira credential ID that is used to authenticate on the endpoint. We use standard credentials, so here you just have to add the credential with the correct ID, so Jira credentials that we retrieve here. How to configure the shared library. So in the configuration of Jenkins, you can define the global pipeline libraries. They can also be defined at the pipeline level. And here you just have to provide the name of the library and the default version that you want to use, and from where you're gonna check out the source code to execute the library. So quite easy to do. Now let's imagine that we want to change the version of our application to ecom.2.23 snapshot. I remove the backup and I push my commit. Again, a commit is triggered, so the pipeline should be automatically triggered. Here we're going to do it or simulate that manually. The pipeline is executed. If I go in Apwide Golive, deployment is ongoing. Deployment is finished. I update. And you see here that we have also this story for the version changes. So I have the 2.23. What is good if you use the Apwide custom field is that when you search for issues here, and I search for the 2.23, automatically I know on which environment this version is available. So on e-commerce dev environment, I have the 2.23. And this environment is available because it's in green. On my tester, I want to access to the application. I just click here and I can access directly to the application from the issue. Application looks to be broken, but it's not the purpose of this demo. I want to promote my build and my artifact to a new environment. I run again the pipeline. This time I want to deploy on demo, run on demo. I let the pipeline running. So the tests are executed. Tests are successful. Deployment is ongoing. So now we see that we have the deployment that is ongoing on the demo environment for e-commerce. Pipeline just finished. If I go back in the pipeline, we see that it's demo, deploy on demo that has been executed. I update the environment and now here we have the version that is available and the status of the environment plus additional information about the application. Again, I search here and automatically I know that this version is now available also on demo. So I can test it, this on demo, access on demo, and test the application. So really easy to integrate. So that's pretty it for me. I will provide you all the details on the Confluence of Apwide and also in the description of the video. Thanks for watching and have fun. Bye.